discussing about the new chapter is musculoskeletal system. The musculoskeletal system. In this system, nothing but the movement or locomotions are there. Useful for the muscle and skeleton, both are useful for a particular structure of the body. Give you a particular structure of the body and useful for the locomotion. What is that? The muscle and skeleton, both are useful for, essential for the locomotion, and as well as give a particular structure of the body. So what is that? The musculoskeletal system is known as a locomotion. Locomotion and movement. And movement. Listen carefully. Locomotion and movement. So first one, the locomotion and movement, though there is a two words are there. Okay. So the skeletal and muscle both are together to show movement and locomotion. Are you clear? We know that. That is clear. What is the difference in between of the locomotion and movement? Okay. We are ready to get the information, the clarity information about them. What is the movement? What is the locomotion? Difference in between of locomotion and movement. Movement and locomotion. What is the movement? First of all, what is the locomotion? Locomotion is nothing but the displacement of the organism is called as a locomotion. What is that? Displacement of the organism is called as a locomotion. So what is the movement? The movement is nothing but there is no changing of their position. The organisms are never changing of their position, but it shows some kind of what is the movements that known as a movement of the organism. I will give you the best example for easy to understand what is the difference in between of the movement and locomotion. Are you clear? First one, what I'm saying, the movements are shown by, the movements is nothing but, movements are shown by animals and plants. The movements are shown by animals and plants. How can I able to show? So I will give the best example. So in our body, so in our human beings are, I am never going anywhere, but I can move my, what is that, organs. That is called as a movement. Nothing but we cannot able to change my position, but I can able to move a particular organ. That is called as a movement. What is the movement? The organism cannot able to move anywhere, but it anywhere nothing but it is cannot able to changing their position, but it can shows the movement. That is called as a movement. What is that? First one, first example, a branch of the tree, a tree are the animal, the organism, the human beings are, I am staying here, but I cannot able to move anywhere, but I can going to anywhere, but I cannot able to change my place, change my position, but I can moving my hands, my heads, my jaws. So that is known as a movement. So what is the locomotion? I can move somewhere, nothing but I can changing my position. It is known as a locomotion. That is called as a displacement of the organism. So that is known as, the trees have a leaves, the leaves, but leaves are moves. Yes or no? Leaves are moves, but these are attaching into branches. Is attaching into branches. Okay, these are only shown movement, but not displacement. The animal, the organism, first of all, the animal is sedentary. Some example of the one animal, like a Coelenterata and some of the hydras. I will give the example of the hydra animal. Listen carefully. The movement, I will only explain the movement. The hydra is sedentary in condition. It has attachment of the substratum region. It is cannot able to move anywhere. It is shown sedentary in nature. Nothing but sessile in. What I am saying? Sessile in nature. But how can I able to show move? So these are sedentary in condition. That containing more number of the, what are they? Tentacles are there. The tentacles are there around their manubrium. Around their manubrium, their tentacles are there in the anterior region around the manubrium. But the organisms are still, still placed on attachment of the substratum. But the tentacles are moves. Tentacles are shown movement. Tentacles are shown movement. So that is called as a movement. The organisms are shown any movement, but the organs are shown as some kind of, what is that? That is called as a movement. Movement. So this movement, the tentacles are useful for catching prey. Catching prey. Hunting predators. So this is known as a movement. This is called as a movement. Next one, what is the locomotion? The types of movement, types of locomotion. Next one is known as a locomotion. What is the locomotion? Locomotion is nothing but the displacement of the organism. Listen carefully, everyone. The displacement of the organism, nothing but the organisms will be changing their position. That is called locomotion. The displacement of the organisms. Are changing position. Changing position is called locomotion. Are you clear? Changing position is called as a locomotion. Displacement or changing position. I will give the example. Yeah, so the human beings are there. So these all there is a resting in condition, nothing but they are getting sleeping. Okay, so their body, nothing but the contraction movement is occurring. There is no contraction locomotion. The contraction movement is occurring, nothing but the rhythmic movement was occur. That is known as a contraction movement. Nothing but rhythmic movement was occur, but there is no locomotion. So the human beings are doing a number of the works from their changing of their position. From I am here to after I am changing my position to right here. So that is known as a locomotion. Locomotion is an example of free living organisms. Organism. Example, the plants also, some kind of plants are also shown free swimming nature. Example, what is that? Algae and what is that? Chlamydomonas. The Chlamydomonas and algae are also, these are under comes into plant kingdom. But these are also shown movement or locomotion. Movement and locomotion. Some of the plant individuals also, plant organisms. Like, what is that? Algae. What is algae and Chlamydomonas. So these are shown. What is that movement or locomotion? The types of the locomotion. The types of the locomotion. So what I am saying, the locomotion is depends on skeleton and as well as muscle. So some of the individual in the animal kingdom, the most of the individuals, nothing but primitive individuals are shown non-muscular movement. And muscular movement. Some of the individuals are shown non-muscular movement and muscular. The two types of movements are shown by the animals. So we are discussing the animal physiology, nothing but human physiology. These are how in the in the introduction they are giving more and more and more examples for the locomotion of the organisms. Okay, first one, the according to their involvement of the organ, the movement is classified into two types. According to their involvement of the organ, this movement is classified into how many types? Two types. Let's discuss. Listen carefully. First one is non-muscular movement. And the second one is muscular movement. non-muscular movement and muscular movement. What is the non-muscular movement? In this movement, there is no involvement of the muscle. In this movement, there is no. Yes. In this movement, there is no involvement of the muscle, but the organisms are shown movement. The organisms are shown movement. That kind of movement is known as a non-muscular movement. Okay. Some come from the primitive to highly developed individual. Come from the what is the primitive to microscopic to multicellular. From protozoans. The protozoans are microscopic in nature. So these are don't have any muscles. These are completely shown protoplasmic levels of the organization. Are you clear? The protozoans are shown. What is that? Protoplasmic levels of the organization. So this type of individuals are shown movement. Which type of movement? Locomotion. Which type of movement? The movement is known as pseudopodiary movement. Nothing but Salgel mechanism. Pseudopodia. Nothing but legs. Pseudopodiums. Nothing but amoeba shown. Some kind of movement, some kind of displacement of their position. Are clear? So these are absence of locomotory organ, but the cytoplasm comes into outside of the body and able to formation of a finger like projection like this. First one is protoplasm. In protozoa, listen carefully, this is very important in NEET level examination. Protozoans. First one is protoplasmic movement. First one, the protoplasmic movement, the amoeba, there is no particular structure. If it is want to be moved, they are able to formation of number of the projections. Are you clear? These projections are known as a podians. Podia, nothing but leg. These are attachment of the substratum for want to be moved. That is called as a movement. That is not a locomotion. It is slightly changing of their position. That is called as a movement, not a locomotion. Okay. The protoplasmic movement is nothing but the body of the protozoa containing more amount of the cytoplasm. If the amoeba wants to be moved, when the protoplasm will be, what is that, high pressure was creates there in this plasma gel to plasma cell mechanism, the projection was comes out of the cytoplasm, able to formation of a projections, like a finger like projections. These finger like projections are known as a lobopodia. This type of locomotion is called as a protoplasmic movement. Are you clear? In protozoans, the protozoans are shown protoplasmic movement, and this is commonly known as a pseudopodia. This is called as a pseudopodian. Pseudo, nothing but false podians. The organisms are shown false podian movement. Are you clear? Yes. The second one, in protozoa consistent of rhizopoda. This is commonly known as a rhizopoda. What is the meaning of the rhizopoda? Rhiza, nothing but arising. Poda means podia, leg. Podia. The arising of the podia from the outside of the body through the cytoplasmic region. So this is known as a pseudopodia. Next one is a flagellata. Flagellary movement, not a flagellary locomotion. This is known as a movement. These are absence of muscles, but these are consistent of a long whip-like organ that is known as a flagella. It is useful for movement of the organism, useful for the locomotion of the organism. First one, flagellary movement from slightly displacement of the organism. Example, Euglena. The Euglena, it is a The Euglena comes into plant and animal kingdom. The Euglena organism comes into plant and animal kingdom. Why? Because it is have a similar characteristic features of the plant and animal characteristic feature. What is that? It containing plant characters. Euglena containing plant characters and animal characters. So this comes into plant and animal kingdom. In between of plant and animal kingdom. Plant and animal kingdom. So what is that? The plant character. What is the plant character? These are consistent with chloroplast. That is one of the plant characteristic feature. Containing chloroplast is one of the plant characteristic feature. Animal containing this known as a locomotory organ, nothing but flagella. That is called locomotion. Locomotion. It is animal character. Chloroplast. It is a plant character. So it is introducing into plant and animal kingdom. So in between them. Next one, coleophora. Coleophora. The coleophorans are also shown a movement. Which one? The cilias are shown a movement. Example, paramecium. Clear. Next one. The third one is hydra. Very important. Hydra. So these hydras are absence of the muscle. Are you clear? The hydras are absence of the muscle, but these hydras are consistent of the longitudinal and circular muscles are there, but these are absence of true muscle. This hydras undercomes into cylindrata phylum. The hydras are consistence of longitudinal and circular muscles are there. These are useful for shown a locomotion and movement of the organism. So which type of movements are there in hydra? There are absence of circular. So these are absence of muscle. But presence of which type of muscle? So two different type of muscles are there. First one is longitudinal muscles. The second one is circular muscle. These muscles are essential. These muscles are useful for movement of the organism. Okay, clear. Yes. First one, the movement of the hydra. The hydras are shown somersault movement. Somersault movement. Like somersault movement. What is the looping movement and a walking movement. These three movements are there. Not a locomotion, the movements are there. First one is somersault. Somersaults. Somersault movement. Somersault movement, nothing but the organisms are, which one? The hydra. Let's see the, this is a substratum. Substratum. The hydra undercomes into freshwater nature. So hydrozoa undercomes into hydrozoa. So the hydra. Yes, this is hydra. When the hydra, when it is attachment of the substratum, when it is want to be moved, when it is shown, one of the movement is known as the somersault movement. In this movement, the anterior region of the suckers are bent. Anterior region of the suckers are will become, this is the anterior region. This is the posterior region, direct attachment of the substratum. The posterior region attachment of the substratum. Are you clear? The posterior region of the substratum, attachment of the substratum. When organisms want to be moved, the anterior head region will be attached into the substratum like this. This is a, you want to be moved, this is the posterior region and the anterior region, both are attached into the substratum. Are you clear? Organisms want to be moved when the posterior region directly fused with the substratum. First movement, it is a normal in condition. If it is want to be moved, the anterior region will become bent and attached into the substratum. When the posterior region bend and anterior, both regions are attached to the substratum. Posterior and anterior, both regions are attached to the substratum. Okay, clear. So after when this anterior region, when it is attachment of the substratum, the posterior one will become free. The posterior one will become free. That type of movement is called as a somersault movement. Somersault movement. So in the somersault movement, useful for the longitudinal, nothing but large muscle. Longitudinal muscles are useful in this for the somersault movement. Longitudinal muscles are useful, and somersault movement useful for the circular muscle. Okay, circular muscle. What I am saying, it is not a muscle, it is one of the branches of the muscle. Okay, it's a types of muscle, not a branch, it is the types of muscle. So this is known as the hydras movement. First one, somersault movement. Second one is, are you clear? The organisms are want to be moved, when it is attachment of the substratum. So it, if it is want to be moved, the anterior, the posterior region will become attached. After, the anterior region will also bend and attach to the substratum. So the anterior and posterior regions are both are attached in substratum region. Anterior and posterior both are attached to the substratum. That condition, that position is called somersault position. So when, after this, when the anterior region will be attached, the posterior region will become free. So the posterior region will become free, the anterior region will become attached. And after, again the anterior region will, anterior region again attach, anterior region to the posterior, the posterior region will become binded. So next one, the anterior region will become free. So that is the movement is called a somersault movement. Okay, clear? Next, what is the somersault movement? And next one is a looping movement and walking movement. Looping movement. Looping movement, nothing but loop, like a loop. When it is attachment of the substratum. Next one, the hydra. When it is attachment of the substratum. Okay. So the hydra will become bend, loop. The posterior one is free. This type of movement is called as a looping movement. Looping of the movement is called as a, that is called looping movement. Next one, walking movement. Walking movement. When the walking movement, the hydra, the anterior, the posterior region will become attached, the anterior region will become free. When it is the anterior region will be attached, the posterior one will become free. Like this one. Free, anterior, anterior and posterior. When the posterior region of the organism, the posterior region of the organism will be attached to the substratum, anterior one is free. Like this movement, like this. Like this, anterior region and posterior region is attached, anterior one is free. When the anterior region will be attached, the posterior one will be free. Like this, the anterior, when the posterior one is attached, the anterior one free. The anterior one is attached, the posterior free. The posterior attached, anterior free. Like that movement is known as a walking movement. So this type of movements are shown as a non-muscular movement. Non-muscular movement. Like in earthworm also shown. Earthworm shown. Setae movement. Setae movement. Clear. And a leech shown. Leech shown. Sucker movement. Sucker and looping movement. Looping and walking movement. These are very important from the examination. And next, last one is Echinodermata, starfishes, fishes are shown, ambrolacral movement, ambrolacral movement are water vascular movement, ambrolacral and water vascular movement. Yes, this is the non-vascular movement, non-muscular movement. Next.